You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be praised. My Redeemer, you are worthy to be praised. You are the Alpha and Omega. Beside you, there is no other, there is no other God. Alpha, Omega. Beside you, there is no other God. Your name is I Am, above other names. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Lord. Your name is I Am, above other names. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Lord. Is the Lord. Is the Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. Is the Lord. Hallelujah. Every day shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Savior. Thank you so much. I know you are here. Good morning, Jesus. Oh, good morning, Savior. Thank you so much for giving me a brand new day. Anyabiawo Chineke, Anyabiawo, Anyabiawo, Icho Jio Bani Keya, Sineni Gwe Gentio, O Mugabia Ruola, Sineni Gwe Barata, Ndi Boro Kwe Lutewo, Ikede Nelu, Ikede Nala, Ikede Nebe Nine, Aha Jesus Kareyam. Father God, we thank you this morning. Everlasting King of Glory, the Lion of Tribe of Judah, the Prince of Peace, the Rose of Sharon, the Lily of the Valley, Blessed Redeemer, Jehovah Amasua, Eli Ikabora, the Puntu Puntu, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, King of Glory, the Lord of Hosts, the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, the Holy One of Israel, the God of David, the God of Prophet Williams Onoha. I thank you this morning. I thank you for what you have done. I thank you for what you are about to do today. Lord, we reference your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. You are the Adonai. You are the Elohim. We bless you. We thank you for as many that will come for this program today. We thank you as many that will come later to see this program. Lord, use it to bless your people. We say thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Brethren, good morning and good afternoon and good evening and good night for some of you. My name is Prophet Williams Onoha. We are live this morning from Galilee Christian Center, Lagos. My name is Prophet Williams Onoha. And some of you, Onoha means the mouth of everybody. The mouth of everybody, Onoha. That is my name. I want you to invite somebody now. Begin to share this program. It's a special program that somebody must be blessed today. Share this program. Share it. Invite your people. Invite somebody now. Begin to share this program. This is a prophetic word. Share it and you'll be blessed. Share it and somebody you'll be lifted today. Share it and you'll know what the God of a prophet can do. Share it and you will see you will never remain the same. Share it, you will have a surprise from now to 4 p.m. as the Lord liveth. Share it to and invite your friends. You have a surprise from now to 4 p.m. if I be a servant of God. Share this program and invite somebody. you will see what the Lord will do. Because as you are sharing, you are spreading the gospel. Because in Mark 16, verse 15, the Lord said we should go to the world and preach the gospel to every creature. As you are going to share it now, you are preaching the gospel. Remember in Proverbs 11:30, the Bible says, he that winneth soul is wise. As you are doing it, you are winning soul. Somebody may come across this program today and be blessed. You have done something, and your name will be written in the book of life. Because that is what Jesus said to the disciples in book of Luke 10. Oh, verse 19, verse 17. The Bible tells us that the disciples, they came to him, they were so excited. They said, Master, even demons were subject to us in your name. Jesus said they should not rejoice, verse 20, that their names have been written in the book of life. Because why Jesus said so? Because they move around spreading the gospel of Christ. Hallelujah, somebody. Share this program and somebody will be blessed now. Do it because it's a command from God that we should do the work and we should spread the gospel. Because in Daniel chapter 12, verse 3, say, those that turn men into righteousness, they shall shine forth like a stars of heaven. Somebody, your time has come for you to shine. Share the program today and you'll be blessed. Invite somebody now. Use this medium to do the work of God. Use this medium to preach the gospel, because somebody will be blessed, because there is a servant of God present over this program today. I am telling you prophetically and authentically that you are going to be blessed. Something will happen to you from now to 4 p.m. today. I am speaking as a prophet, because Elijah, a prophet like Prophet William Sonohan, stood when there is a trouble in the land. In book of 2 Kings chapter 6, from verse 37, 39, the Bible said there is a very heavy famine in the land of Israel, that nobody, everyone, there is no food, even for the kings, and even for the king's household. There is four lepers in that city. They sit at the gate, nothing to eat. And the king said, I know that somebody is causing this problem. I know that somebody behind this problem. I want to tell you that every genuine prophet is always a problem to an evil administration. Every genuine problem is always a problem to occultic world. Every genuine prophet is always a problem to these witches and wizards. The king said, I know that somebody who is hiding behind this mess. His name is Elijah. I am going to behead him today. Oh, Elijah was busy discussing with the elders. He said, look at this evil king. Look at this evil king. He has conspired how he's going to kill me. As Elijah was discussing, the messenger now knocked in and came in to invite Elijah to tell him that the king wants to see him. What did the man of God say? The man of God in 2 Kings chapter 7 verse 1, because that is a famine, he said, by this time tomorrow, there will be a miracle in the gate of Samaria. Somebody, I'm speaking to you from now to 4 p.m. as the Lord liveth. From now to 4 p.m. as you share this program today, as you fight your people, from now to 4 p.m. if I be the servant of God, you will have a testimony that will shock you. Elisha said, from now to by this time tomorrow, there will be a miracle in the gate of Samaria. That a shekel of barley shall sell for a shekel. And somebody was there who tried to doubt what God can do, who tried to doubt the power of a prophet. The second in command, the man that the king take answers from. Verse 2, the man said, even if God himself can make windows from heaven, can this be? The man of God responded and said to him, you shall see it with your eyes, but you will never eat from now. Hallelujah, somebody. And it came to pass, as the man of God said that it's going to be. The Bible tells us that verse 4, the four lepers said, why should we sit here and die? That is a heavy farmer in the land. If we keep on sitting on this gate, we are going to eat. People do not have food, let alone to give to us. If we go inside the city of Samaria, we will still die. Let us take a drastic measure. Let us take a drastic decision. Let us go to the camp of Syria. If they keep us alive, we live. If they kill us, we die. And they move. Do you know what happened? Because God, the Bible tells us in Psalm 24:1 that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. God made the Syrian to hear the sound of these four lepers. The four lepers. Ndori adejihi kadagija. Ndori adewehe power hadagaje. Ndori adelaguruji. God made their sound, their footstep, to sound like a truce. You can imagine what God can do. God made the Syrians to hear them coming. The noise and everything was too heavy. The Syrians said that these people, Israelites, have gone to hire the Egyptians and other neighboring nations to come and join hands to fight them. What did they do? They flee. If God can make four lepers that are very hungry, if God can make four lepers that are sick people, do you know what leper? Sick people. Hana agij, hana agashike, heji yume, heji power. But Chineke me, iji hana uruzie, iji igwe madu, igwe ndara. The Syrians, they flee from their land. And they went inside and began to pack. They went ahead and they said, oh, verse 9, why should we keep this? This is a day of good news. Somebody, I am speaking to you this morning that this today is a day of good news for everyone listening to this program. This is the day of testimony. We can't keep it till tomorrow that we are going to be punished. If you don't share this, you are keeping the testimony of the Most High. We must go and spread the news. They went and told the king, and the people now had enough food to eat. The Bible tells us that the second the command that always sit with the king now send him to go and see. He saw people and they trampled him to death for doubting the word of the prophet of God. Anytime I speak with authority, because in Deuteronomy 18 verse 22, say, how do you know a true prophet? Say that shall speak and it shall come to pass. In book of Numbers chapter 12 verse 6, the Lord God Almighty said, if there is a prophet among you, I will speak to them in a dream, in a trance, in a vision. Prophet. Who are the prophet? In Hosea 12:13, the Bible said, through a prophet, he brought them out of Egypt. Through a prophet, he preserved them. In Psalm 105, verse 37, the Bible said, they left Egypt with silver and gold because the man of God said to them, you will eat this food in the house, in the book of Exodus chapter 12. You will do this, and God of Israel will give you favor before the Egyptians. Somebody that is favor coming upon you, spirit of favor coming upon you, spirit of favor that you will destroy your enemies. The Lord, I will give you favor before the Egyptians, that you will go and borrow as many silver and gold, so that when you left, you will have something to take care of yourself. That grace is available because in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8. The Bible said that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. God never changed. I want you to get it this morning. Spread the gospel. Tell somebody that it should come. Our message this morning says, he that is in me is greater than he that is in the world. That is my message this morning. He that is in you, child of God. We are not talking about Christians anymore. Me, personally, the word Christians and disappointment have come from the Christianity. I don't call Christian anymore. I call the children of God, believers, the people of God. Hallelujah. A true child of God should know that he's not alone. You are not alone. There is power behind you. There is spirit behind you. Hallelujah, somebody. You should stop panicking and fearing. The Lord said, he that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. What is it? In book of 1 John chapter 4 verse 4. He that is in you. In book of John chapter 3 verse 31. Say, he that cometh from above overcometh them all. You are not just a ordinary candidate. You are not an earthly candidate. You are coming from somewhere. You overcome them all. You are above them all. Hallelujah, somebody. He that is in you is greater. The power that is in you is powerful than the doors of the enemies. Can you see what happened to Moses in Exodus 7 verse 1? Exodus chapter 7 verse 1. The Lord God Almighty said to Moses, you are God to Pharaoh. Pharaoh is in charge. Pharaoh is the king of Egypt. Pharaoh had all the equipment and the army and every facility to do whatever he wants. But God said to Moses, you are God to Pharaoh. You are God to Pharaoh. That is whom you are. You are not just an ordinary person. In Psalm 82 verse 6, the Bible tells us that you are the children of the Most High. You are God. That is whom you are. You are not just an ordinary person. There is something in you that demons, they will see and they will flee. It doesn't mean that you are a child of God, that is, troubles will not arise. Problem will come. So many things will rise. But God is speaking to you this morning that you fear not, that he that is in you is greater. There is power inside you. Somebody I'm seeing now. There are angels of God surrounding you up and down. Fear is our greatest enemy. Immediately you begin to fear your enemy. Immediately you begin to think of something else and begin to panic. You are in trouble. Remember what happened to Jesus and Peter. Peter said, Master, if it's you, command me that I should walk on the water. Because Peter saw Jesus walking on top of the water. Said, if it is you, command me. And Jesus said, come. And Peter was walking on top of the water, boldly and confident. But immediately the spirit of fear came upon Peter. Peter began to sink. That is fear, what fear can do. In Proverbs 28 verse 1, the Bible said, the wicked flee when no one is chasing them. And the righteous shall be bold like a lion. Somebody, God has put the spirit of a lion inside you. Stop hiding yourself. That is something. Forget about your present condition. Your tomorrow shall be greater than today. Forget about what is happening. You are just going through trials and training. This is a time of training. Time of trials. You come out victoriously. Nothing will happen to you. Your enemies will not kill you. You are a child of God. Doesn't mean that trouble will not come. Isaiah 54:15. The Lord says, surely they will gather. What is he trying to tell us? Surely they will gather. Your enemies will gather. Witches and wizards that have seen whom you are, they will gather. But the Lord said, because I am not the one who permitted their gathering, they shall scatter. Verse 16, he tells you he is the one that created calamity. He is the one that formed, made the man that formed the instrument of war. Verse 17, he said, no weapon formed and fashioned against you shall prosper. That is the promise of the Most High. No weapon formed and fashioned against you shall prosper. And the Bible tells us, the last verse, said that every tongue that will rise in judgment, anywhere they are, try to judge you, try to speak evil against you, you that is watching this program today, the Lord said they shall be condemned. Do you know the last verse of it? He said, this is the heritage of the servant of the Lord. This is what God has given you freely because you are a child of God. You are a servant of God. You believe in him. You can never be put to shame. That is assurance from the Most High. Because in Deuteronomy 28 verse 7, the Lord said they shall come in one way and they will scatter seven times. Your enemies will come in one way, they will scatter seven times. The enemies must come. Psalm 68 verse 1 said, arise, O Lord, let our enemies be scattered. Every enemies of your life, anywhere they have come, gathered against you, they shall scatter. Because the Bible tells us about sworn enemies, those that have taken oath, and their plan is to take your lives. They can't do it because of what? They are not the one that giving you the life. God is in charge. Before Satan can do anything, he must seek permission from the Most High. If you read the scripture in book of Job chapter 1 verse 6, the Bible tells us that children of God gathered in the presence of God, and Satan also came, because Satan is also a child of God. And the Lord said to Satan, can you see my servant? Do you see Job? No one is like Job. Job is a man without blame. Is a man who served me truth and the spirit. Satan said to God, did Job serve you for nothing? He served you because you have blessed him. You have made his increase, his possession to increase in the land. You have put hedge around all he possessed. Do you know what Satan said? Satan said to God, permit me. He can't just do something on his own. Permit me. Allow me. Give me the order. Give me the authority. Let me go and touch him. You will see that he will curse you to your face. God said you can do anything that pleases you, but never you touch his soul. If you are afraid that somebody is going to kill you, that person can never kill you. He is not your creator. Any day you die, that is the day that God has assigned for you to die. Are you hearing me this morning? If anybody is threatening you, sending assassin, they will not succeed. Remember what happened in book of 2 Kings, chapter 6, from verse 13. The king of Syria said to the people, "Who is it that who have been a spy among us? There's an informant among us." One of them said to him, "King, there is no informant. There is one man called Elisha. He's in Israel. All the things he does, even inside their bedroom, he sees. He sees because he's a prophet." And the king had information that Elisha is in Syria. He said, "Let us go and round him and kill him." Verse 15, Gehazi, the servant of Elisha, woke up in the morning and he saw that the place now is being surrounded by the Syrian army, troops. Syrian army have surrounded everywhere to take their lives. Gehazi came in and said to Elisha, "We are doomed, we are finished. These people have surrounded us. We are doomed. I went outside, I see the chariot. I see the army. I see their horses. They are all over, waiting for us to come out so that they will capture us alive." What is the response of Elisha? Elisha said, that these people are nothing. Them that are with us are greater than those that who are against us. I pray that God will open your eyes." He prayed and God opened the eyes of Gehazi, and they saw that all the mountains and hills were covered with the chariot of the host of heaven. Somebody, the Spirit of God is with you. He that is in you is greater. Satan cannot kill you. You will be the one to decide what you want to do with your enemy. You are the one to decide whether to kill them or to leave them. But as for me, I will tell you to kill them, because in Exodus 22:18, the Bible says, "Suffer not the witch to live." You don't pray for them to repent. You speak for them to die, because authority has been given to you. They can't hurt you, because he that is in you is greater. Are you afraid of anything? Afraid of this is a lie. Shouldn't be afraid, because in Daniel 11:32, the Bible said, "Them that know their God, they shall be strong, and they will do exploit." What is it that this morning that is giving you sleepless night? I am assuring you that your enemies will not see you, because in Isaiah 43 verse 1, the Lord said to Israel, "You are mine, you belong to me." The Lord said, "If you walk through the fire, it will not burn you, neither will it scorch you. If you pass through the water, the river will not overwhelm you, because I am there with you." Can you see what happened to Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego in book of Daniel chapter 3 verse 16? The king, the book of Daniel said, "Nobody can save you from my hand. I don't know those are in authority that are threatening your life. I don't know those evil personalities that they have given them money to chase and to take your life. I am speaking to you now that they will not succeed. I don't know how many people that have gathered against you this morning. I don't know how many that have conspired to kill you. I am speaking to you this morning that the Bible said that surely they will gather. But the Lord said, I am not the one who permitted them, they shall scatter. I don't know where the meeting is taking place. I don't know how many nations that have joined hands to take your life, to rise against you. But this morning I'm telling you that all the plans of enemy against you and your family shall scatter today. It can never stand, because Isaiah 7:7 said, "It shall not come to pass, neither will it stand." The plans of the enemy will never stand in your life. Nebuchadnezzar is nobody, because Nebuchadnezzar is the king that ruled the world at that moment, at that time. He said, "Nobody can save you from my hand. When I take decision, nobody." Verse 16. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego said, "Oh, Nebuchadnezzar, they removed the majesty. They removed to put all the titles. They said, oh, Nebuchadnezzar, the God we serve," somebody that is watching, "the God we serve is able to deliver us from your hand. The God we serve, the living God, Because Daniel 11, 32, they that know their God, they shall be strong. These people, they knew their God. They said, the God we serve is able to deliver us from your hand. Even if our God did not come, we are not going to bow down to this rubbish. We are not going to bow down to your threat. We are not going to bow down to your military. We are not going to bow down to your police. We are not going to bow down to anything you possess. Because he that is in us is greater. We will not bow down. Who are you? Where do you get your power? We will not bow down to the witches and wizards. We cannot bow down to any power at all. Because the God we serve is able to deliver us. The God we serve is able to do all things. The God we serve is able to change every situation. The God we serve is able to heal every manner of disease. The God we serve is able to lift somebody from nothing to something. The God we serve is able to do impossibility to become possible. The God we serve is able to do things. The God we serve is able to deliver us from your hand. The God we serve is able. Even if our God did not come to save us, we cannot bow down. That is a message to somebody this morning. We will not bow down to any threat. We will not bow down to any assassin. We will not bow down to those that are coming with strange. I have a vision about this. I want to tell the media team to get that vision, to publish that prophecy that I released. That I saw where I was, went to the station. People with the uniform, they invited me or they came to arrest. I went there. That's the vision I saw. As I was going to the office where they called me to come, somebody with a needle, a strange, now tried to inject me. Now tried to inject me. I saw it and I knew there's another plot to kill my people is to inject them. They want to inject people. They want to arrest somebody, they will inject that person, the person will go home and die. Or before they will release that person, the person will die. They want to inject people this hour. This is another plan, this is another plan. This is their plot. But the God we serve is able to deliver us. Anybody that is waiting to take your life from you, that person will die before you. Whoever, what happened to Haman will happen to them. Those that are digging any grave, they will fall into that pit, no matter where they belong, no matter the court they belong, even if they are in 20 or 50 courts. I beg those courts to be neutralized this hour, because the Bible tells us in Revelation 19:16 that Jesus Christ is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. In Colossians 2:10, said that Jesus is the head of all principalities and powers. In Philippians 2:9, said that God has raised his name above every other name, and at the mention of his name, every plot against you must bow. Somebody, I'm preaching to you this morning. Those of you that are in prison, those of you that are in cell, they are planning to inject you. They are planning to give you evil injection. They don't want to kill again with bullet. They want to kill with injection. This our God of heaven, that injection, they want to inject you. God will turn it. They will inject it to your generation. Inject it to their children. Inject it to themselves this hour. As many that have conspired to wipe you from the face of the earth. Why should we be afraid? These people, they are in a strange land. These are the true Hebrews. They were in a strange land. And there was a heavy conspiracy against them. It has been like this. Conspiracy. In the time of Mordecai, there was a conspiracy to wipe out the Jewish, the Israelites. To wipe them out. And in my own time, there is a plot to wipe out my people. But I'm telling you that it's not going to succeed. The victory is ours. If you are watching this message, you are a witches and wizards, you are among those who are planning to wipe or planning to inject or planning to arrest, or planning to kill, or planning to send their police or whatever army to send assassin. I want to tell you, you are disappointed this hour, because the Bible tells us that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. For he hath found it upon the sea, established it upon the waters. Who shall ascend unto the hill of the Lord? who shall stand in his holy place. He who have a clean hands, who have not lifted up his soul to an idol or swore deceitfully, he shall receive blessing. This is generation of them that seek him, that seek the face of God of Jacob. Salah. Lift up your hands, all you gate, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your hands, all you gate, and King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Are they planning? Is it threat around you now? Have the people tried to take your life? I want to tell you that David said in Psalm 27 that the Lord is my light and my salvation. God is the light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked came up to eat up my flesh, the wicked came up to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fall. Though an army may camp against me, war may rise up against. In this will I be confident. Child of God, God is telling you to be confident. In this will I be confident. Child of God, God is speaking to you to be confident. In this will I be confident. One thing have I desired from the Lord is to dwell in the house of the Lord and to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, there are always time of trouble. You are not the one who created the time of trouble. The time of trouble comes from the Most High. Because in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, 1, said everything that happened at the time he chose. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his secret pavilion. Somebody, God is going to hide you in his secret pavilion. And he's going to set you upon a rock. Somebody, God is going to set you upon a rock. Upon a rock. And your head shall be lifted above your enemies round about. Your head shall be lifted above your enemies. Because nothing will happen to you. In Joshua chapter 1 verse 5. The Lord said to Joshua, no man shall be able to defeat you. No man shall be able to kill you. No man shall be able to rise against you. But verse 6, the Lord said, be courageous and be confident. Somebody, God wants you to be courageous. Fear not! He that is in you is greater. They are looking for a way to track you. They are looking for a way to get you. In John 14:30, Jesus said that the prince of this world, the God of this age, came to me and they found nothing. Somebody, they will find nothing to hold you. They will find nothing to track you. Somebody, they will find nothing to get your life. They will find nothing because Jesus said, the prince of this world, the God of this age came to me and they found nothing. This morning I declare as a prophet of God that they will find nothing to get you. Fear not. Remember that fear is our greatest enemy. In Job chapter 3, 25, Job said, what I have feared for have come back to me. Fear. Elijah was killed. Elijah, they could not kill him. But the ministry began to fall when he became afraid. Because in book of 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 1, Jezebel swore that he must kill Elijah by this time tomorrow. Elijah flee for his life. Why should you run, child of God? He flee for his life. From verse 14, the God said, go back. Anoint somebody to take your place because you are afraid of this ordinary mortal. You are afraid of this woman. You are afraid of somebody that you are subject. You are afraid of him. You are afraid of her. The Lord said, go and anoint Elisha to take your place because you are afraid of this person. Why should you be afraid? Anoint Jehu to take the office of the king because just Ahab will die. Somebody must take the office. Anoint Jehu. Anoint Jehu to take office of the Syrian. If this one could not do it, this one will do it. If the prophet Elisha could not do it, Jehu will do it. Or king of Syria will send them to come and fight Israel and defeat them. That is it. Anoint them. Elijah was afraid because of one woman. They got The chariot took him away. He now came back. He came back. For those of you that doesn't believe in reincarnation, there is reincarnation. I believe it strongly. Adiayowayo, he now came back. The Bible tells us about Elijah. About Elijah. In the book of Matthew 11, verse 14, say if you are willing to believe that John is Elijah, whose coming was predicted. John is Elijah, whose coming was predicted. John is Elijah. Elijah flee because of Jezebel. The Bible tells us that in New Testament, it was the wife of a king also that ordered for his head. He who fight and run will fight again. Child of God, fear not. Nothing will happen to you. The only person that have a final say in your life is God. Remember that David is a man of full of faith. David is a man who believes strongly in what God can do. In 1 Samuel chapter 17, from verse 23, the Bible tells us about how Goliath was threatening the children of Israel. Nobody to challenge him because he have the resources. When David came, even his own brother, I don't know how many people that are discouraging you now. Do you know how many calls I've received? Why should you do this? Why should you say that? Do you know how many people that are, oh, they will kill you? How? Where do you get the power to kill me? Who are you to kill me? Am I a politician? Am I a businessman? My work is to speak the truth. If you don't, and secondly, my name is Onoha. Onoha means anything I'm saying now, whatever I talk, anything I talk now, anything I say now, now me and you talk, means Onoha. If you don't get it. Onoha. Anambra said Onoha. Imo said Onoha. Onoha means you are always in your mind, you cannot speak because my name is Onoha. Me and you talk. If you want to kill, first of all, kill yourself before you kill me. You will kill yourself because it's in your mind. And because God have let me honor her. And whatever we say, now me and you talk. He don't know. If you want to kill me, you first of all kill everybody because I am the man. My mouth is just here. Anytime I want to talk, I'm not the one talking. As I'm talking now, something is speaking through me. You first of all go and kill that thing that is speaking, not me. Honor her. Williams means defender. You see, you have nothing to hold me. Jesus said, the prince of this world came and he found nothing. You have found nothing. You can't get me. You can't track me. You can't, because my name is Onoha. Anything I'm speaking the mind of 1 billion people. I'm speaking the mind of 70-something million people. I'm speaking the mind of people. Onoha Nobi, but I cannot speak out. But because of my name is Onoha, I speak. I now take it from you and speak it out. Now, if they want to do anything, they first of all get you. That's how it is. You will judge it. Why should we be afraid? The Lord said, he that is in us is greater. Why should you be afraid of that situation you find yourself? God is preparing you and remove fear from today. Nothing will happen to you. Even in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 28, Eliab, David's elder brother, said this. You are insolent. You are arrogant. How can you come here? But this could not discourage David. David was bold. Verse 32. David said, people should keep quiet. People, let their mind not troubled about this man. Saul said, how can you do this? David said, I take care of my father's flocks. Whenever a lion come after them, I'll go after the lion. With this my hand, I've killed bear and I've killed lion. The same God who delivered me from this lion also delivered me. That's the boldness we are talking about this morning. He that is you, you should not be afraid. Verse 43. Goliath said to David, he cursed David with the name of their gods. He must be an highly occultic man. Verse 45, David cursed back with the name of the Most High. Any man or woman seeking to take your life in the name that is above every other name, because in Philippians 2 verse 9, at the mention of his name, that every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. And the Bible also tells us in Psalm 91 verse 14, because you have known my name, you shall call upon me and I will answer you. And the Bible tells us in John 14, 14, that anything we ask in your name that you will do. And you are the one who said in Psalm 15, verse 15, call upon me in the days of trouble, I will answer. In Jeremiah 33, verse 6, call upon me and I will answer you, and I will show you things that you have not seen. Father, I am calling upon you this hour to every man and woman following this program. Any man or woman that will share this program today, as many all over the world that will rise against you, anywhere they are cooking and plotting to destroy your life, God, you will arise and destroy them now. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray for you, because anything conspiracy, because in book of Psalm 83, our God will not sleep again. Our God will never rest, because said he that keepeth Israel will not sleep or slumber. The God will never rest until he destroy your enemies. Psalm 83. Psalm 83 says, oh, do not keep silent, O God. Do not hold your peace. Do not hold your peace. We are speaking to you this morning. Say, do not keep silent, O God. Do not hold your peace. And do not be still, O God. For behold, your enemies are making a turmoil. And those who hate you have lifted up their head. They have lifted up their head. They have taken a crafty counsel against your people. The witches and wizards, the children of darkness, have taken a crafty counsel against the children of the light. They have taken a crafty counsel against your people and consulted together against your shattered walls. Against the shattered walls. Who are those that are shattered walls? We. Against your shattered walls. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation. Let them cut us off. Let them cut your family off. Let them cut you off for you not to succeed. This, they have taken a crafty counsel. Anywhere they have gathered against you and your family, any meeting that is going on this hour, Lord God Almighty, I am calling and I'm relying on you, because I am have the assurance you said in your word in Psalm 91, that he that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, him I will trust. Surely he shall deliver me from noise pestilence. He shall cover me with his feathers. Under his wings shall I trust. His truth shall be my shield and buckler. And I shall not be afraid of terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor pestilence that walk in darkness, nor destruction that lays at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at my side, 10,000 at my right hand, but it shall not come near me. Only with my eyes will I look and see the reward of the wicked. Because I've made the Lord my defender, the Most High my protector. No disaster will strike me. No violence will come near my home. God will put his angels charge over me to protect me wherever I go. And they will hold me with their hands. I will dash my foot against the stone. I will trample upon lion and young lion and dragon and serpent. Because he has set his love upon me. Therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble, and I will deliver him and honor him with a glad. And I will satisfy him and show him my salvation, my God and my Savior. I pray for everyone, genuine men and women that are following this program today. Because in Isaiah 3:10, the Bible said, tell the righteous that it shall be well. Everyone following this program this morning, I am here to announce to you that it shall be well with you. I am here praying for you that every gang up, plot against you, assassin, those that are waiting for you with evil strings, they want to inject you. I call upon Jehovah. I call upon Elohim. I call upon 24 elders. I call upon heaven this hour. I call upon third heaven and the hosts of heaven to fight them now and destroy them. Any man or woman, whoever they want to give such assignment. Oh, God of heaven and earth, arise in your anger and fight the battle of your people. Because you said in the word in Exodus 14, verse 13, oh, he said to Moses that he should fear not, that today he shall see the salvation of the Lord. And you said you will fight our battle and will hold our peace, that the Egyptians will see, we shall see no more. Every man and woman watching this hour, whoever that stands and as an Egyptian upon you and your family, anyone is standing as an Egyptian upon your life, this hour you shall see them no more. Let me hear your biggest amen. Every King Uzziah, oh, according to the word of God in Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1, the Bible said, after the death of King Uzziah, Isaiah saw the Lord. Every King Uzziah troubling your family, I command them to go down today. In the name of Jesus, anybody that has been a household, because in Matthew chapter 10, 36, the Bible tells us that the worst enemy that a man will have is household enemy. Anybody that has given assignment to monitor you, anyone who has taken bribe, anyone who has given money to monitor your footstep, to monitor your conversation, to monitor your the phone call, to monitor anywhere you go, I decree this hour that God Almighty will visit that person in the name of Jesus. Anybody waiting for you, I pray this morning they shall wait forever. Because the Bible said, tell the righteous that it shall be well. Oh, in Isaiah 3:10, verse 11 said, tell the wicked, every wicked man and woman that are watching Prophet William Somoha this morning, you are watching, boasting because you have an army, boasting because you have a police, boasting because you know who is who. But I remember what the Bible said in some in book of Jeremiah 17, verse 5. It said, curse is upon that man that will put his trust in a fellow man. Because our trust in God. Because David said in Psalm 1, Psalm 118, verse 8. Psalm 118, verse 8. Oh, Psalm 118, verse 7. My God. Anyone? Psalm 118 verse 7 says, the Lord is for me among those who help me. Therefore, I shall see the, my desire on those who hate me. Somebody will see their desire on those who hate you. Verse 8 said, it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in a man. It is better to trust in the Lord than put confidence in a prince. All nations, verse 10 said, all nations. I don't know how many people, nations that have ganged up against our people. I don't know how many nations that are planning to wipe us away. The devil said, all nations surrounded me, but in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them all. All nations, all the troops and evil people. Psalm 118 verse 10. All nations surrounded me, but in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. They surrounded me, yes. Yes, if you don't know they surrounded you, know it now. If you don't know that the enemy have circled you, know it now. If you don't know they are monitoring you, because in Joshua chapter 6 verse 1, the Bible said the gate of Jericho was kept shut, that the children of Israel cannot go out and come in. They used the gate of wall of Jericho to monitor the children of Israel. Anywhere that place such walls in your family, in your village, in your town, in your nation, this hour they will go down. All nations surrounded me, but in the name of the Lord I will destroy them. They surrounded me. Yes, they surrounded me. But in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. Verse 12 said, they surrounded me like bees. You know how group, like bees, they were quenched like a fire of thorns. For in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. In whose name? The name of God. the name of the Most High, the name of Jehovah, the name of Elohim, the name Jehovah Amashua, the name we will destroy them anywhere they are this morning. Because the Bible tells us, tell the righteous that shall be well. Verse 11 says, tell the wicked that it shall never be well with them. Every wicked man and woman watching this program today, oh, you will meet your doom. 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 You evil men and women that derive joy when people are suffering. You blood-sucking demons. Your time is up. Your time is up. You that are plotting how to wipe my people. You that have given money to inject them. Hey! God will visit you this time. Because David said in Psalm 121, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From where comes my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made the heaven and earth. He will not suffer my foot to be moved. He that keepeth me will not slumber. He that keepeth Israel will not slumber sleep. The Lord is my keeper. The Lord is the shade upon my right hand. The Lord is my keeper. The Lord is the shade upon my right hand. The sun will not strike me by day, neither the moon by the night. The Lord shall preserve me from all evil. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. The Lord shall preserve my soul. The Lord shall preserve me going out and coming in from this time forth and forevermore. Somebody, hey, you have lifted, you are blessed. I pray for you this morning. The Lord said, fear not, because he that is in you is greater. You are not just an ordinary person. There is power of God upon you. God has given you power. God has given you power. Because in Luke 10:19, he said, I've given you powers to trample upon snakes and scorpions. And no power of the enemy shall be able to hurt you. No one can hurt you. No one can kill you. In book of Revelation chapter 9, the Bible said he give order. Revelation chapter 9, I want you to see this morning. Oh, are they waiting for your head? They will see their own. They will not kill you. They will kill their own family. Revelation chapter 9 from verse 1. My God. Then the fifth angel sounded. And I saw the star falling from heaven to the earth. To him was given the key to the bottomless pit. Verse 2. And he opened the bottomless pit. And the smoke arose out of the pit like the smoke of the great furnace. So the sun and the air were darkened because of the smoke of the pit. Verse 3. Then out of the smoke a locust come upon the earth. And to them was given power. As the scorpions of the earth have power, they were commanded not to harm the grass of the earth or any green thing or any tree, but only those men, look at it, but only those men who do not have the seal of God in their forehead. They told them the only people you can touch are people that do not have the seal of God in their forehead. Somebody, I place the seal of God upon you this morning. I place the seal of God because in Psalm 105, verse 14, it said, God permitted nobody to wrong you. He permitted no one to touch your life. He permitted no one to touch your business. He permitted no one to wrong you. And he rebuked kings for your sake. 15 said, touch not. Touch not. It's a command. Touch not. And do my prophet no harm. Anyone who tried to rise. Because in Galatians chapter 6, 17, it said, because I bear the mark of Jesus, let nobody trouble you again. Because God said, touch not. Touch not. In Numbers chapter 12, verse 8, the Lord said to Miriam, what right do you have to speak against my servant? They were just speaking against Moses, and God struck them with sickness. Let alone anybody who is planning to hurt you, anybody who is planning to assassinate you, anybody who is planning to do something, to send somebody to harm you, that person is in trouble from today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because there is a decree from heaven. Touch not. You are lifted. You are blessed. You are going higher. They can't stop you. Fear not. Because in 1 Peter chapter 3:13, said, if you are a follower of what is good, no one can hurt you. No one can harm you. That is the scripture. In book of Romans 8:31, said, if God be with me, who can be against me? That is for you, somebody. No one can be against you. Any meeting against you, I scatter those meetings. In the name of the Most High God, I bless you that it shall be well with you. I bless you that anything you touch this time shall prosper. I gave 7 days. Oh, that those of you that will share this program this morning, keep on sharing it now. That from now to 4 p.m., I speak and I prophesy to someone. From now to 4 p.m., God of heaven and earth will visit you. Because your time is a war also after faith. The Bible said the time has come to favor you. There's that time. Everything that's causing reproach and shame upon you, you have been taken away. Because in Luke chapter 125, Elizabeth said, at last, God has taken away my public disgrace. Whatever that makes you, give you public disgrace, reproach upon your life and your family, God has taken it away this morning. In the name of Jesus, God has taken it away. Did they bury charm in your father's house and said nobody will succeed? Did they bury charm where you are building a house and said you can never finish that house? Because in Matthew 15:13, the Bible said every seed that is not planted by God shall be uprooted. I call the host of heaven, the angels of God, to go and uproot that charm now. You have a testimony. Did they say you will not conceive? It's a lie. Because in Deuteronomy 7:14, the Bible said none shall be barren. Barrenness is not your portion. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will conceive this hour. Are you facing miscarriage as a child of God? Remember in Exodus 23 verse 26, it said you will not suffer miscarriage, neither barrenness. Every seed of miscarriage, I curse it now. Because in book of 2 Kings, chapter 2 verse 19, the men of the city, they said to Elisha, as you know, sir, look at the situation. The land is pleasant. The ground is barren. The water caused miscarriage. The water caused miscarriage. Anything that is causing miscarriage in your life, anything that's causing barrenness, barren business, this morning I give order. I stand as a prophet of God Almighty. I'm not just a prophet today. I was ordained in my father's house the way David was ordained. For that reason, you can't kill me. You can't kill me. Because David is a man of war. And let me say, Nanito, where do you get your power? Okoko. Ijebwe. You have forgotten. In Hosea 4, says that my people perish for lack of knowledge. I'm angry here. You want to finish your generation. You want to go and a hot, anointed man. You are doomed. Because I said, let my people go. I said, you cannot torment my people. You think I'm an ordinary pastor? You think I'm one of the occultic idiots? You think I'm somebody that somewhere, somebody will tell somebody I speak? Listen, we are too big for that. We murdered fear years back. If I give you my story, you know that you are a case. You was a bad boy. You went to university and they give you gun. They joined force and joined this one. Our own, we murdered fear years back. Far back. We murdered fear. I would have fear. Boy, I won. I'll give you my story next Tuesday, and you will know that easily sleep the webem nobawa. Onyem chuan nasibu, onyem chuan nasibu. I bless every one of you this morning. I bless the people of God. I bless the children of the Most High. I bless the great Biafrans across the world. I bless the Igbos. I bless the children of God, all over the world. Shall be well with you. I bless you in the name of God the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. See you on Sunday. It's going to be powerful. On Sunday is our anointing service. Come and worship with us. Remember David said in Psalm 122, verse 1. I was glad when they said, let us go to the house of God. God bless you.